Moving from one place to another, how do we go? We go using vehicles. Now, these vehicles emit various forms of pollutant, carbon and its derivatives. It could be in the form of carbon dioxide, it could be in the form of hydrocarbons, but derivatives of carbon are part of it. Now, what we need to understand is whatever we consume on a day-to-day basis, even the houses that we live in, the buildings that we are there, these are coming, like the material is coming from some industries. Now these industries discharge what? They actually discharge the pollutants in various forms, and this could be in the form of carbon again. So when we are consuming various things on the planet, we need to understand that we are one of the major causes of this rising pollution levels, and this rising levels of carbon into the atmosphere has to be actually absorbed by certain factors. Otherwise, what would happen? If the amount of carbon in the atmosphere keeps rising, there would be higher amount of carbon dioxide, leading to global warming, increase in the temperature. Now this increase in the temperature would ultimately lead to glaciers melting, and the melting of the glaciers would ultimately lead to increase in the sea level. So it's a kind of interlinked cycle that we would understand. So rising sea levels would lead to submergence of the coastal areas, and so on and so forth, right? So to break this chain apart, what we need to understand is the carbon which is released into the atmosphere has to be absorbed in some form or the other. Now, if we talk about the natural powers that absorb the carbon, the best among them would be plants, because plants actually use this carbon dioxide and give us oxygen through the process of photosynthesis. But plants are not just one of those. Soil is another important way through which carbon is captured. Forests, another major carbon sink. Oceans, another major carbon sink. But the key thing here is all these are actually the places where, or the areas where, carbon sequestration could be done. That means the carbon sequestration and storage, as we call it as CSS. Now note, this is not the CSS which is the language, which is the way that we study computer science, right? The term that we study in computer science. But here we understand that the sequestration is important, because this would ultimately help us to balance out the amount of carbon into the atmosphere, right? To understand this further, there have been various IPCC studies which have been done, and according to that, 110 billion tons of carbon in the next 50 years could be sequestrated only by the forest. Now, there have been artificial ways through which carbon sequestration can be done and have been developed. But these artificial ways through which you are creating a sink where you can accumulate all the carbon and take it underground, where in long run it could turn out into formation of coal over the years of thousands of years, right? But that is a tedious process, that's an expensive process as well, right? So under this, we need to understand that worldwide the emissions of the carbon have been there, but now countries have come onto a equilibrium where there is a deal, we can say, between the developed nations and the developing nations, stating that some of the nations would be doing the pollution, and in line of the carbon that is emitted into the atmosphere in those countries, there would be the purchase of those credits which would be done by the developed countries. So most of the carbon emitting regions would be, let's say, India and China, the credits being brought by Europe, and when Europe buy these credits, they would spend those for activities where they would go for carbon sequestration or storage or reducing the pollution by one means or the other. But this is a good way. Practically, when we speak, the major thing that comes out here is, though that this is a good way of balancing the actual amount of carbon dioxide into the atmosphere or the carbon derivatives into the atmosphere, but the key issue here is there are developing nations which are are at more risk, but because ultimately the level of pollution in the developing states or the developing countries would be higher as compared to the developed nations, and this would be detrimental to the livelihood conditions and the environmental conditions in those areas, leading to further burden on healthcare in those areas. Now, this carbon trading globally at present is somewhere at around $5 billion, and India's contribution is around $1 billion. China is largest seller of carbon credits, accounting for 70% of the market, and MCX has become the first exchange in China, first exchange in Asia, to trade the carbon credits. Now, as we said, this whole story of carbon sequestration, carbon credits comes into light with climate change. And this issue of climate change has further enhanced because of the rising amount of carbon dioxide into the atmosphere, which increases the problems of greenhouse gases, and carbon dioxide being a greenhouse gases, ultimately having an impact onto the global warming, as we already studied. Now, if we focus on India, as one of the nations, right? So India has the second largest population, now towards the first largest population in the world. Then in terms of energy consumption, we are the fourth largest energy consumer in the world. We have the third largest greenhouse gas emissions in the world. And then the amount of the greenhouse that we burn, or the fuel wood that we burn, is nearly 10 times higher than that done by United States. So again, we have a huge burden onto the environment for the same. Now, the green energy for cleaner sources have to be increased, and India is planning to move towards renewable sources of energy. So we plan to upgrade our renewable sources of energy from 35 gigawatts to 175 gigawatts, and then